Thank you. Welcome, John. Thank you so much. Bring Dawn.
Tell the story because it made me laugh anyway. He was just telling stories one day and he told this bizarre story of how he, when they were first putting, when he was working with David Lynch and they were putting Blue Velvet, I think, to DVD initially. And they got all the stems, which are the sounds and different things, from the De Laurentiis company, which had helped produce it. And they were missing some of them. And one thing they were missing were crickets in the scene where Laura Dern, if you've seen the movie, is hiding in a bush naked. And Kyle MacLachlan is walking down the sidewalk. And anyway, the crickets from this scene were missing. So John said, I knew there were some in the straight story, so I went and grabbed those. And I was putting them in, and David came in and he said, what's going on? And I said, I'm adding crickets to this scene. He said, but what is happening? And John said, and I said, I don't know what you mean, David. What do you mean? What is happening? He goes, well, the crickets, those are day crickets. Those aren't night crickets. And Sean was like, oh. Because apparently there's two different sounds. So they corrected that, but I just thought that was such a great line. So it wasn't surprising to me that nothing we threw at him really shocked him. He was a genuine, heartfelt, beautiful human being who I truly loved. And that short space of time that I got to really know him and have many lunches with him in between sessions. So I'm really pleased to be here, and I sadly have to leave because I have all these other things that I was already doing today. So thank you for letting me talk.
Heart, oh my God. Thank you so much. Yeah. So we'll put the other mic back on. So we're going to have Casey McBride. He's going to come up and play a couple songs.
Thank you
so much.
Okay.
Okay.
I like the volume. You like it?
Yep, sounds good up here. All right. Well, I want to thank Christy for having me here, too. I met John through Christy. I played drums on the first two albums, and that's how I got to know John. And I did a couple other projects with him after that. It was always such a pleasure. He's like the only guy that I know that likes the studio as much as me, I think. But I had a chance to do a couple solo songs that I'd written, and I wanted to record them, but not something that I usually do, get up and sing and play guitar. So it had to be somebody that I felt comfortable with, and John was definitely that guy, man. He made it, you know, being in the studio really easy, and definitely gonna miss him. So I'm gonna play this song. It's called Get the Soul Back in Your Sound. Well, there's a message getting clearer, but you don't want to listen at all. Like headlights to a deer, it only takes a moment to stall. And everything runs aground, ain't nothing ever gonna be the same. And the reflection in the mirror is looking for somebody to blame. Well, isn't it a shame? I think it's time to light up. Get you on your feet again. Well, there's a certain kind of fear, it's hard to put a finger on. Have you crying in your beard? Never let you finish writing the song. You make it a wild hair, but you ain't ever let your guard down. The way you're dealing is no good. It's time to take a look around. Are you happy what you found? Go get the soul back in your sound. Yeah, get the soul back in your sound. Get the soul back in your sound. get the soul back in your sound. That's all. I'm just doing one song. Thank you, Chrissy, for having me. And I'm sure John's looking down on us all here and very happy to see all these fine people. This is really, really nice. And I want to thank Ken, too, for providing all the backline equipment for everybody. It's a lot of work. So, all right. Well, thanks a lot, Chrissy.
I started seeing a lot of posts by my musician friends giving him a lot of love. And we actually did a show that evening. I still haven't put two and two together, but we actually played a bunch of songs, and it's an honor. So it's really a trip to find out the next day that a good friend of mine is his daughter. So I saw her at a show Friday, and I was like, "What should I play?" And she was like, "Well, John liked a lot of different kinds of music." So we have a kind of a Louisiana connection. You know, we're in a Mardi Gras crew together. We've been to Jazz and Heritage Festival in New Orleans a handful of times together. So I thought I'd start with a little Professor Longhair. Next song is a J.J. Gray song. This is a song that my bandmate asked for me to play for him on Wednesday, so I thought this is a fitting song. My tongue pockets tight and my thoughts drift away. Glory, glory, hallelujah. The sun is shining down. Glory, glory, hallelujah. I'm alive. And I'm feeling, Lord, feeling fine. All those simple thoughts, all those peaceful dreams share the space with the hard, hard work days. And it's the little things, not expectations that make life worth living, worth living. Glory, glory,
time in the studio, because I've only ever made one record with
honey.
Aww. Yeah, we did. He came out and hang out with us on the boat. It was awesome.
Yeah.
Watch Christmas ships. All right.
Yeah.
This is the title track from that CD that he helped us with. Well, I believe. First thing I told him I wasn't a guitar player, and I played some for him, and he told me, "You don't suck. You've got style."
I don't wanna be the one you don't believe in. I don't wanna see the sunrise with doubt in your eyes. I just wanna take tonight, make you believe in me. And I know that someday we'll by morning we'll see that the love I'll give you is when you have a little doubt in your mind, come a little closer, girl. I'll tell you everything will be just fine. Come a little closer. And when you feel me softly touching your face, come a little closer, girl. You know I only want to be with you. Only want to be with you.
To record with him.
More on the last song. Because the last song's the best one, probably.
A little Frenchy kind of number. Red wine.
most of every minute of your life. Don't be afraid of anything. Put your bat wings on. I'm afraid to tell you that our gig was the last gig John saw on December 19th. And the reason I'm afraid is I hope he didn't get sick there, you know? So I got this fucked up guilt. I know, but I'm Ukrainian, I feel guilt. You know, the Jews and the Ukrainians have a lot in common, especially guilt. But I know he liked this Ukrainian song because he told me a couple times. So here's a little Ukrainian song about the simple pleasures in life. And we all know that John appreciated those.
Плачет коза, Widely chosen.
Shut up!
Thank you. Thank you. I just can't talk loud. I've been crying a lot, and I lose my voice when I cry. I've been crying for John, and I lost another friend a day later, so it's been hardcore. But I tell you, John had the enthusiasm as a musician of a teenage boy. You know, like when you get your first guitar, and you're like, you got your, like, Jimi Hendrix poster, Jimmy Page poster on your wall. And that's how it felt to see his joy in his post-retirement life. Because he retired less than a year ago or something, like a very short time ago. So this song was written of his era. So it's a song from the 60s. And I think every single verse in here makes me think of the way John lived his last days. Because you saw those beautiful crow posts. You saw those breakfast posts. I fought on his behalf to the hostel to bring back those potatoes. Yeah. You gotta bring those fucking potatoes back or die. And also today's strain is, you know, mellow yellow or whatever. Yeah. Today's strain, like, John's living good. But the crows got me because just all the joy you find in just like simple things. So this is the song for John, if he can hear me. One, two, three.
Kiss all the pretty ones goodbye. My autumn's done come. My
Lisa Lapine. It's probably how a lot of you know each other. And
she got us a job.
So much stuff. So I just feel he was very kind to me when my mother was passing, and that was years, because it was dementia and it takes forever. He was so kind to me all the time and always was so supportive. And so I just want to say that I really feel like he just totally succeeded at life and dying. Like, don't we all just want to like go quickly and painlessly? And I'm just proud of him. Like, seriously, I almost feel like this is like awesome, dude. You just fucking kicked ass at life and then died with not. You know, like, so awesome. So I didn't know what I was gonna do. I'm really bad at these kind of things, but I always get asked to do them. It's weird to be a performer and then have to perform for things that are hard for you. Thank you. Emotional. Yes, absolutely. But it happens all the time, so you think I'd be more professional by now. But all I want to say to y'all is I'm never doing this again. So don't die, because I'm not coming out. I'm not fucking playing your funerals, bitches.
Whatever.
Just quit it. Dying shit. Go somewhere sunny. Keep living. Sorry.
Even in the rain we live. It's okay. We can still live in the rain.
And now I'm just like, so tired. Fucking tired. So I got here. I literally didn't really know what I was even going to do today. And I have these stupid nails on from New Year's Eve. We'll see if I can even play my guitar. If not,
I got
professional back. These guys.
Steve.
No.
Oh, this is still.
Volume all the way up?
Where do we go? I gotcha. Sorry, it's just my input.
No worries.
Do you have this? I may just not play at all.
I mean, yeah, totally. Want me to kick it off?
They got my back, yeah. Here we go. Please sing. I know this might be a silly thing, but I thought, well, if we could have a sing-along, maybe it might bring us all together, so.
Yeah.
This is what my mama would have loved. You know it.
Oh, my God.
When I find myself in times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. Let it be. There will be an answer. Let it be. Oh, I forgot. Okay, so like I said, like I said, I didn't know what I was gonna do, so I just like I thought, okay, do one that Lisa Lapine loved, since that's like so much of our connection. Yeah. This whole thing is A, C sharp minor, and E. When the center is bleeding, they tear out the middle and they send it all away. Tasteless lead sitting on our tongues. Then we have to worry more about the ones we love. When you see the smoke, there's fire. 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 Come the space, the awful. It is coming down, take it on down the line. Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Heaven is based on the way it's coming down, take it on down the line. A little together tonight. I've seen some faces tonight that I know and don't remember names of, and so I hope everybody gets to mingle and say hi, because I know this is true for all of you. All of these webs we weave are the nets that keep us from falling through, right? So let's all make sure that we meet each other before this is over. Play at my funeral if I die before you. But I want you to play topless, like in your 90s. Actually, you can just do whatever you want. Yeah.
Isn't that a lesson?
This is a song we haven't done in like, I don't know, years and years. But it's the first, it's one of the only songs I've written in Spanish, and it's basically about how the roads are long and winding, and I think looking around this room, all the different people that I've met has been through music, and has brought me to meet so many unique, gentle human beings. I would say that John was a true human being. He was authentically present with people. He wasn't distracted by things that didn't matter. He cared about you, and he just didn't have any pretentiousness about him. He just seemed like what a human should be. Even though that seems like a simple thing, like we're human, for some reason that's really difficult for us to achieve. So I agree with you, Chris. I think he achieved a lot. Esta mujer es distraída, soñando todo mi vida. Amar es estar despierta, despertando es un sueño. Thank you.
Let's do one more song.
Let's do I'll Fly Away and everyone can sing.
Yeah.
Thank you, Christy, for organizing us.
Thank you, Christy.
It's not an easy thing to do. So everybody can sing on this one or not. But I know there's a lot of really good singers in this room. But like I'm in Paris. We've got writers and this is a time and place. This is a very, very cool time and place. It's not gonna be here again. I'm glad to be here with you.
Yeah.
You got the inside again.
was trying to think last night, it's a story I could tell that would, like, encompass Dad. And like everybody here, I didn't have one story. I had a million stories. Tons. Just mountains of stories. My first concert. I was 9 years old. Dad's band was opening for Bob Dylan, so I got to go see Bob Dylan.
What?
That's a story not a lot of people... He didn't tell that story a lot. That's a story.
In Hawaii.
Yeah, yeah. And it was amazing. It was, how many kids get to say their first concert was Bob Dylan?
Not many.
When I was in middle school and high school, I got really into metal. And Dad would take me and all my buddies to festivals. We'd go watch Slayer, we'd go watch all these heavy bands and just thrash out, and he would be in this van, he would load us all up, all the kids up, and smelly 15-year-olds in the back of his van. It was amazing. It was great. When I got to college, I studied music. Most parents would be horrified. Dad was all about it. Yeah, it was just amazing. So I didn't pinpoint one thing. Mm. Much like everybody here, we all had a bunch of stories. He shared with us his love of music, and as everybody has said, he was unapologetically enthusiastic. He gave us the gift of being able to tell stories about him, and how many people in our lives get to do that? We tell a lot of stories about a lot of people. A lot of people tell stories about my dad. Thanks to everybody here, we get one last story with John Neff.
Hasn't it just been amazing? What a beautiful send-off. Thank you guys and everybody who's just stepped up so much. It's just been mind-blowing. I couldn't even imagine playing with the band again without John. And so originally I was just going to have Brett and Carl and I do some of the songs. But I was talking to Ken and I said, unless Ken, you wanted to play. And he said, yes. And fuck, that was so amazing. Yeah. And we just practiced once yesterday afternoon. And it was like, it's just so beautiful. And I'm really, really grateful. Yeah, we get to do these songs. We picked out 5 songs. And the first 2 songs are ones that I actually wrote about John. The first one's called Begin Again. And I'm writing it like it's me, but I wrote it about him. Of course, he knew that, because, you know, coming to Portland had been kind of a traumatic thing for him. It came about not because of good events. And so when I first met him, he was still really, really struggling with that. It's about 9 years ago. And we started working on my project, Spark a Ripple, and we did it like a straight sum, so we weren't on the clock all the time. And I got to hear every story, because I was there with every little part of it, you know, from his doing the tubes to the recording and all the people we brought in. And it was Lisa Lapine who brought us together. And John, every time you say Lisa Lapine, John would say, I love Lisa Lapine. I just miss Lisa. She was such an integral part, and she became the executive producer on that project, and she said, okay, you gotta, you know, this is your chance to get to know all the musicians in Portland. You can pick the best, you know, and so when we were looking for drums, it was like Casey, she brought Casey in, and she said, but don't just go with the first person, and we heard Casey, and was like, yeah, we're going with Casey. It was kind of like that for a lot of the stuff, and although Brett didn't play on that first album, we brought in David Langanese. David suggested Brett, saying, you know, he's like, and Brett has just came in and blew us away. And every time we record, we'd be like, what do you think Brett's gonna do? Blow us away. And every time we'd be in the studio, we'd go, right? Oh my God. So it's been such a gift. And Carl played with us the very first time too. And Lisa had also suggested him. And after he played with us or came in and recorded, John's like, that's a world-class percussionist. Yes. That is a world-class percussionist. Yes. Yes. And we have always been so lucky to play with everybody we played with. And God, I fucking miss John. But we're gonna do these first two songs. This one's called Begin Again. Because he did overcome that anger and stuff. He found a place that, you know, it might have, what brought him here, I feel like this was a good place for him. And he connected with this community of musicians here in a real heartfelt way. And that was like a really important and significant part of the life I knew with John. So thank you. Thank you for being here. I can't believe we're saying goodbye, but man, I totally have felt him a lot. And it's hard to imagine moving forward, but of course we will, right? Because that's the way it goes. So, right? So this song is called Begin Again.
What?
My bass cracked out again.
So he's
going to play a track, like guitar. Chrissy? What? Speak
for a moment about your personal relationship with
how he says there's a moment here. The things you were saying to me, if it feels comfortable to you about how he was supportive of your endeavors. And, like, you know, the special relationship that you have, the more personal relationship.
Gosh, that's fucking hard.
I know. Aww. He is such a part of my life. I mean, even since this last week, you know, it's like, I can't wait to tell John, or just all the many, many John-isms, you know, just the things that his deadpan self was such a crack up. And all his little, oh God, he had so many, I just can't even think of them right now, but he touched my life so much. And
you touched his.
Yes. He really connected with my music, so that was like the best. And you know, when I met him, Lisa suggested we get together, and she's telling me all about him, and it's like, no, not someone like that. She said, yeah, it might be a good match. And so she said, send him the stuff. So I sent everything I had done in San Francisco and all the projects I'd done, and I wrote like a 3-page handwritten letter telling him about what I'm doing and who influenced me and, you know, blah, 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 and what I'm hoping for. And 2 days later, I get a handwritten letter, 3 pages long, and he listened to every little thing, and every comment he made about it was exactly how I felt about it. And he'd say, I see that you do this, but really you're doing this, right? And it's like, oh, you know? It was so, I've never been so understood in music, which is like my life, by anyone else. And I'm really gonna miss that, but boy, I'll never lose it. Like, we get to hold everything, right? I know that he's good. I totally know he's good. I'm just like challenged for the rest of us, right? But we should only go it the way we want to. It's kind of how I feel about it. So thank you for being here and celebrating him and the love. And you know, Jen, his daughter, and Ken, and Brian, just such special people, such special people. And they were like the most important thing to John. Music was important, but his kids were the most. Yeah. So, yeah, so much love.
We're gonna do this?
My bass cracked out, so I'm gonna play Dad's guitar.
Maybe he did that on purpose.
Thanks, Dad.
We've had some technical difficulties with that bass. He's like, yeah, I don't want to be replaced by anybody, even my son, you know? Okay, we'll do it different. It got me to do the band part, but you know, right?
Oh my God, that's awesome. He's going to be playing along.
Right? Yeah, listen for the ghost bass. I guess so.
Ghost bass.
All right,
we're going to
get it. Love it. We're going to do it.
Like a
Trickier. It was always kind of a challenging song for us, but I wrote it about John, and it's called Your Mastery. I wrote it in like 2014. It's been a while, but it was like he'd already made such an impact on my life, and this was my little thank you to him.
Right?
As we're gonna be. Thank you.
written a song, the song that I...
Hello? There we are.
I had written a song, the song that I posted the lyrics with when I had to make a Facebook post, but I hate making Facebook posts. And I had played that song for John, and when we were doing our show, our last show together at the CD release party in my backyard, which was just like the sweetest thing. And John went, wow. And then when this happened, it was like, although I'd written it for someone else, because the song's about, like, you know, no matter how difficult or fucked up things are, you know, it's always a wave. You know, everything's gonna change no matter what. Maybe not better, but at least it's gonna change. And I definitely find solace in that. So I was writing this to the person who was in some pretty suffering kind of situation. And then there I was, it was me. So anyway, at the loss, but you know, our loss, it's, I'm so grateful. That's what I come back to, the gratitude, right? Anyway, so it's called Everything Is As It Is. And I started, right? Yeah. So we just learned it. They just learned it.
She told us it was an easy one. She's like, oh, you guys, it's easy. None of her songs are easy.
All right.
Thank you.
got to hear the keyboard more the longer. I love the song so much because, you know, that's what death is. It's the inevitable goodbye. It's the thing. We come in knowing above all else, right? And so the reminder of it to myself and to what I wrote about was that, you know, we really only have today. Always. Are we ready for this, you guys?
Love you.
Love you, Chris. Can you leave your baggage and come fly with me? We'll soar at our adventures completely free of all the garbage. Take song, and it's the one that started it all. And I feel like it's something John would want to leave us all with, and it's called Spark a Ripple. And it's about being that spark a ripple of love, because, you know, you love on anyone, and I fucking loved on John, and look at all of you. I'm so, all of the new people I've met, and just the community, that's just so wonderful, and thank you. Jim Mosley over here, he was going to play with Johanna Keith and the Paradigm Crushers, but Johanna got sick. And Jim Mosley was such a great and kind person to John. He really valued that friendship, Jim. Thank you. So this song is Spark a Ripple, and thank you again. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you, Christy.
Thank you, Christy. Love you all so much. I can't even tell you. Yeah, thank you, Tristan, for doing the sound.
Thank you. You want to check your keys really quick? Looks like it's working again.
Yes, thank you.
Sorry about
that. There was something else I was supposed to say.
Hold on.
I wrote it down.
Oh, yeah.
What was it? Oh, okay.
There you go. Good. I brought a bunch of CDs. John and I did 4 CDs together. So they're in a box back there, and feel free to take one, or 2, or 3, or 4. Help yourself. He would just love that to go out. And the family chose for donations, if anybody wanted to do donations, for the Oregon Music Hall of Fame. They're a great organization that raised funds to help get kids who otherwise couldn't, scholarships to go to school, music school. So it's a great organization. And I have it's over there on that podium thing. It's posted, and I have the link. If you want, you can just take a picture for the link of where to donate, if someone wanted to do that. And again, Jennifer and Ken and Brian, our love.
Yes.
Right? Our love. Your dad was really, really loved.
Yes.
All right, I'm doing this one.
No, all right, here we go. You guys, everybody good?
Yeah. I'm not afraid. problem, contribute to correction, not the drama. Cause baby, ready or not, love is on the way. Thank you. Thanks, John. Percussion, Carl Smith, Casey McBride on drums, Brett Malmquist on guitar, and of course, Ken Neff. Thanks, Ken.